all contain some of the most unforgettable villains in movie history. And villains are the subject of this special show, which we're calling Villains. So bad, they're good. I'm Roger Ebert of the Chicago Sun-Times.
And I'm Gene Siskel of the Chicago Tribune. Why a show about villains? Well, they're more interesting than heroes. They're more critical to an action movie's success than the good guys. And how movie villains have changed over the years may tell us something about our culture and ourselves. And at the end of this special show, Roger and I will each pick our favorite villain in movie history. And you're going to get some good rental ideas out of this show. All of these titles that we're going to be mentioning are available on home video. Concluding now our special show on villains, so bad they're good, it's time for Roger and me to select each of our favorite villains in movie history. And I decided I couldn't really choose among the worst or the most sinister bad guys, so I went out in the left field, so to speak, for my favorite villain, out into space, actually, for the most surprising villain I've ever seen in a motion picture. Let's just start the movie, and I'll let you discover the villain the fabulous way we all did some 27 years ago.
Well, as far as I know, no 9,000 computers have been disconnected.
Oh, no 9,000 computers ever found up before?
That's not what I mean.
Huh?
Well, I'm not so sure what he'd think about it.
Yes, it's the power-mad HAL 9000 computer in Stanley Kubrick's 2001 A Space Odyssey, here eavesdropping on astronauts Keir Delay and Gary Lockwood. Eventually, Delay tries to dismantle HAL over the machine's protest.
I honestly think you ought to sit down calmly, take a stress pill, and think things over.
What's the real evil in HAL? No, not the computer chip. It's the impulse to control others, the people that built the computer. The root cause, I think, of so much of the evil in the world. Unlike most every villain in the movies, even the great ones, HAL wasn't introduced to us as a bad guy. He just shocked us in a way that none of us will ever forget.
And I remember that so clearly, Gene, when I was watching the movie. I thought, oh my God, HAL is not on their side.
Unbelievable.
He's mad because they want to run the space station.
And isn't it true, Roger, that the idea to control is really, if you come down to it, it's what it's the evil person makes the judgment, I have the right to control you.